Hi, welcome to the all new, very exciting virtual versions of the Robust Tools lectures. I'm extremely competent at doing audio and visual things with the internet and such, so you should have no fears whatsoever. I mean, for instance, if we just take a quick look at how I have decided to present myself for this, you can tell that I'm really taking this seriously and know everything what I'm doing. Okay, I am taking this seriously, I promise. But this is very new to me, so let's hope it all works. Okay, so where we're up to, we've covered a lot of material in the class on GitHub and on data visualization, reading data in and out of R. And now what we want to talk about is how to manipulate data and play around with data using the dplyr package. This comes as part of the tidyverse, so this will be stuff that we already have on our machines. So what I'm going to be doing through this is toggling back and forth between my slides and our RStudio cloud project. So the RStudio cloud project for this one is called Advanced with Data. That's the name of the lecture series too. So let's see how this goes. Okay, so to get started on any of this, we're going to need to first be in the cloud. So if you go to RStudio Cloud, here's the project number. It is 1006868. If you go to click on this link, it'll open up the relevant project. We're also going to need some data to work with, and I find that when talking about data manipulation, it's kind of nice to be able to work with interesting data. So this is a data set called the Small World of Words, and I was involved with collecting this data, so I know a little bit about it, but it's not the core of my research, and so the credit for all of the cool data should go to Simon Dedain, who's the first author on this paper, The Small World of Words, English Word Association Norms for Over 12,000 Q-Words. And so here are some links that you can go to find out about the data set. But essentially what the underlying data set is a huge database where we collected online. We got people, we would present them with words like cat, and then you say, okay, what's the first word that comes to mind after I say cat? And you might say dog, or you might say kitty, or something like that, right? And so then you've got this big, if you get enough people doing it, you get something like 4 million responses, then you get a big database of exactly how words are organized in the lexicon and how they and what this tells us about the structure of human semantic representation. So there's a lot of fun things you can do with this data set, and that's what we're going to work with for this module. So what we want to do to get a sense of what's going on with this data set is first we're going to import it into R. So we talked about this in the last sections when we were talking about the say hello to your data module. We talked about how to use the read CSV function to pull in data from a comma separated value file. The nice thing about those functions in tidyverse is that they will automatically read from zipped files, and they come in some nice helpful variants that, for instance, if your data set, as will be the case for this one, is represented as a tab separated value rather than a comma separated value file, you can just use the read TSV function to read it. So we're going to do that. We're going to do our usual thing of we'll create a script as we go, and we're going to load up tidyverse. So that's the library tidyverse command here. We'll use read TSV to open up the file, and I'm going to include this additional line that will not make any sense to you right now, but we have to do it. So I'm going to do this and then ask you to take it on faith that this will make sense at the end of the module. All right, so let's have a go at this. Here we are. So I will go and create a new script, and we go file, new file. I'm very good with this menu. Okay, there we go, new script. Cool, this will work. So we should do our usual thing of going, here is a script for the dplyr. This is also a keyboard that I'm unfamiliar with, hence I'm doing things like putting things in all caps when I normally wouldn't. Okay, and let's get rid of caps lock. And I would normally put my name. and a date, etc. But the point is, I'm just trying to get you into the habit of doing that. So we've got a comment that says load packages. So none of this is doing anything interesting yet. We'll always need our, okay, so library, tidyverse, that will work. And then we go read the data. And so we go SWO0 or SWOW. Yeah, I know. Get, so we go read TSV. And then the file that we want to use is one of the ones that is comes with the in the package project. That's the word I'm looking for, project. So here, if you want to see, so dataswow.csv.zip. So that's what we want to do. Data, and I'm just going to go tab so that I can bring up the things that I need. And there it is. Okay, and now the mystery line, which I'm going to ask you to take on faith. I'm normally a better typist than this, really. Although you've seen me type, so you probably know that I'm not much better than this. So swow to mutate. And what did I say? I think it was going to be ID equals, that should be an equals. There we go. 1, 2, in. Okay, so there's the basic script, and we will go save this as my script .r perhaps, yeah, that'll work. Okay, so we save that, and then we're gonna go over here to source, and we see the usual output that you would get from this, which is saying, okay, so it's attached a whole lot of packages from tidyverse, so that's this section of the output here. What it's noted is that there's a whole bunch of files in a zip archive over there. It's parsed it, and looks like we've got something. So over here in the environment tab on the right hand side, you can see swow is our data. So if I just type at the console swow, we see, yep, we've got a tibble that has variables Q, response, R1, N, R1 strength, and ID. So the Q is the word that you were given as a Q word, so that could be A, and you might say A, B would be the response. The number of people who said B was 9, and that's the R1 variable, out of a total of 97 people who were asked, that's the N variable. So the R1 strength variable is just the ratio of these two things, so 9 over 97 equals 0.09, so that's a measure of what we're going to call associative strength, and ID is just the row number. So it's just saying this is the third entry out of a total of about, yeah, 500,000, so it's not a small data set. Okay, so now let me remember how to do this. I tap back over here. Okay, so we've got our data, and we have some nice looking variables in our workspace. Although, when I look at them, there is a bit of an issue that I'd like to do something about. Those variable names are not the most informative ever. So there are some tools that we could use to automatically clean up the data set. And so there is a package called Janitor, which will be installed inside the project. So we could go library janitor, and you could just go and use the clean names function to create variable names that look like this. So Q response R1 and R1 underscore strength and so on. That is often in the wild when you're dealing with real world data sets is a super useful way to get okay variable names, and it cleans up a bunch of things that can be wrong with real world file names. So that's handy. But it's not exactly what we want here, so what I'm going to suggest instead is that we do manual name cleaning, and this is actually where we just go and rename all the variables in our data set according to what we want them to be. So what I'm going to do is take the swow variable, and I'm going to go rename, so I'm going to pipe it to the rename function, which is part of dplyr, and the format here is the new name equals whatever the old name was, comma, new name equals whatever the old name was. So that's, so if I want to rename my my R1 variable to be nResponse, in the first line here I get nResponse equals R1. And that should give me output that looks a little bit like that, so that I have more of a sense now of what each of these variables are, because I can read them off. Okay, one of them is the queue, one of them is the response, the next one is the number of responses, the next one is the number of total trials in the study, this is a measure of associative strength, and this is our ID number. So okay, let's have a go. I will now tab back, remembering that I know how to do this. I'll go just clear my screen again with Control L. Let's pull this open again and kind of go to remind myself. I'm just going to, in the console, type swow. Oh yeah, I'm totally on top of this. Okay, swow. And so I'm going to take these names as our old names, and I'm going to create some new ones. So we go in here, let's clean the names. You can tell I can remember which keyboard I'm supposed to be using. So here we go. What we're going to go is swow gets, and we take the existing version of swow, and we go, we will pipe it to rename. So we want to go, we want to rename things, where we go the new name equals old name. So the new name I want is nResponse, and that is equal to the, we set that to the new name for what is currently called R1, and then I can go nTotal equals n, and then we go strength equals, and what is it currently called? R1 dot, remember these things are case sensitive, so R1 capitalist strength. Okay, and that should work. So I will again save my file, and I go source, and we get essentially the same thing, but let's, again, I'll clear my screen, give us a bit of room. Let's go over here and then go swow. And now you can see we have renamed the variables according to what I want. So that's our first little act of data manipulation, data cleaning. It's a small one, changing the names to something that you like rather than the ones that come in the default, but it is better than it's better than nothing, and it's a useful first pass to do in any real analysis. So going back here, we now have an exercise. So what I'm going to do is say, you should go into the exercise dplyr 01 file in the project, write your comments at the beginning, load tidyverse, load the data, use rename to get the new variable names. If you've been typing along, as I hope you have, then you'll have most of the script already, but what I'm going to do to, firstly, to help segment these recordings, and also just to see that if I've actually recorded it properly and do things in small units, I'm going to stop this recording, save it, and then you can pick up from the next one. And from the next one, we will be starting with filtering data.